Hello student, today we study about biotic agencies for cross-pollination. So biotic agencies means living agencies. It may be insect or bird or bat. So the pollination which takes place with the help of insect, it is called as entomophily, and such flowers are called as entomophilous. These flowers, they show some adaptation. So these flowers are large, they are mostly brightly colored with attractive color. Pollen grains are large and sticky. Flowers pollinated by moths are strongly scented. Stamen and style, it may be mobile for easy contact with body of insect, and stigma is sticky. So this pollination which takes place with the help of insect, it is called as entomophily, and these are adaptation. The second one, that is ornithophily, bird pollination. The pollination which takes place with the help of birds is called as ornithophily, and such flowers are called as ornithophilous. So adaptation, the flowers are mostly brightly colored to attract birds. Second, the nectars are produced at the base of corolla. Pollen grains are produced in large number. Pollen grains are sticky. Flowers are big. Stigma is located in nectar gland. So example for this ornithophily, they are bottle brush, while the example of entomophily, salvia. The third one, that is chiropterophily. So the pollination which takes place with the help of bat, these are called as chiropterophily. The adaptation, that is flowers are white in color. The second one, flowers are night blooming. Because bat is nocturnal animal, it is active during night. So these flowers, they are mostly open at night. Flowers are produced in group. They are large in size. They produce sweet odor. Stamens are large in number. So these are three biotic agencies, that is entomophily means insect pollinated, ornithophily that is bird pollination, and the third one that is chiropterophily that is bat pollination. So these are three biotic agencies for cross pollination.